This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Libertarians have differing opinions on the validity of intellectual property contents 1. Political parties 2. Anarcho-capitalist views 3. Left-libertarian views 4. Ayn Rands views 5. Other libertarian and anarcho-libertarian views 6. References political parties. The Libertarian Party of Canada takes a moderate approach to patents and copyrights, calling for a careful review of existing and proposed legislation. Anarcho-capitalist views. Since anarcho-capitalists oppose the existence of even a minimal state, this ideological framework requires that any functions served by intellectual property law promulgation and enforcement be provided through private sector institutions. Murray Rothbard argues for allowing contractually arising infinite copyright terms and against the need for any government role in protecting intellectual property. He states that government's involvement in defining arbitrary limits on the duration, scope, etc. of intellectual property in order to promote the progress of science and useful arts is inherently problematic, since by what standard do you judge that research expenditures are too much, too little, or just about enough? He argues that intellectual property laws can actually hinder innovation, since competitors can be indefinitely discouraged from further research expenditures in the general area covered by the patent because the courts may hold their improvements as infringements on the previous patent, and the patent holder is discouraged from engaging in further research in this field because the privilege discourages his improvement of his invention for the entire period of the patent, with the assurance that no competitor can trespass on his domain. Morris and Linda Tanhill propose that ideas in the form of inventions could be registered in a privately owned data bank. The inventor could then buy insurance against the theft and unauthorized commercial use of the invention, and the insurance company would guarantee to not only compensate the inventor for any losses suffered due to such infringement but to stop such unauthorized use. Opponents to intellectual property rights include Wendy McElroy, Tom G. Palmer, Henri Lepage, Boudevain Bocaert, Jeffrey Tucker, and N. Stefan Kinsella. Kinsella points out in Against Intellectual Property that patents may be inefficient since they divert resources from research and development to patent filing and lawsuits. He notices that theoretical research can not be patented as easily as practical research, and thus theoretical research is relatively underfunded. Moreover, he argues that property rights can only apply to resources that are scarce, which intellectual property is not. Kinsella also claims that the only way that intellectual property rights can be implemented is by limiting others' physical property rights. David D. Friedman takes a neutral stance on intellectual property, claiming there are good arguments on both sides of that question. Left-libertarian views. Roderick T. Long argues that the concept of intellectual property is not libertarian. He holds that prohibiting people from using, reproducing, and trading copyrighted material is an infringement of freedom of speech and freedom of the press, and that since information exists in people's minds and other people's property, one cannot own information without owning other people. Claiming that authors and publishers will continue to produce absent copyright protection, he cites the fact that hundreds of thousands of articles are uploaded onto the internet by their authors every day, available to anyone in the world for free, and that nearly all works written before the 20th century are in the public domain, yet pre-1900 works are still published and sold. Benjamin Tucker, opposing intellectual property, writes, "The patent monopoly consists in protecting inventors against competition for a period long enough to extort from the people a reward enormously in excess of the labor measure of their services. Law establishes the property right of a mind to that which it has brought in existence." She held that patent should be granted for limited terms only. If it were held in perpetuity, it would lead to the opposite of the very principle on which it is based. It would lead, not to the earned reward of achievement, but to the unearned support of parasitism. It would become a cumulative lien on the production of unborn generations, which would ultimately paralyze them. Consider what would happen if, in producing an automobile, we had to pay royalties to the descendants of all the inventors involved, starting with the inventor of the wheel and on up. Apart from the impossibility of keeping such records, consider the accidental status of such descendants and the unreality of their unearned claims. Other libertarian and anarcho-libertarian views. Anarchists such as Lysander Spooner and J. Neil Shulman have also argued for forms of intellectual property, as discussed in Kinsella, Classical Liberals and Anarchists on Intellectual Property, which also lists other classical liberals and anarchists and their positions on intellectual property. Kinsella's post-pro-IP Anarchists and anti-IP patent Attorneys list some more recent anarchist libertarians in favor of intellectual property for further discussion of the views of various libertarians on this matter. See his anti-IP resources, the four historical phases of IP abolitionism, and the origins of libertarian IP abolitionism references https://ulibertarians/platform-libertarian-party-canada chapter 3 triangular intervention. Misesorg retrieved the 21st of June 2009. Carrot Bouillon, Hardy 2009, A Note on Intellectual Property and Externalities. In Hulsman, Jorg Guido, Kinsella, Stefan Property, Freedom, and Society, Essays in Honor of Hans Hermann Hoppe Ludwig von Mises Institute p. Digital Rights Management Gripsite Intellectual Property Legal Aspects of File Sharing Mashup Digital Videos Music Music Piracy Orphan Works Patents Biological Software Software Patent Debate Trolling Public Domain Concepts All Rights Reversed. Alternative Compensation System Anti-Copyright Notice Business Models for Open Source Software Copyleft Commercial Use of Copyleft Works Commons Based Peer Production Free Content Free Software License InfoAnarchism Libertarian Positions Open Content Open Design Open Music Model Open Patent Open Source Hardware Open Source Software Prize System Contests. Share a like video on demand movements access to knowledge movement anti-copyright cultural environmentalism free culture movement free software movement organizations copyright alliance creative commons electronic frontier foundation free software foundation open rights group organization for transformative works the pirate bay pirate byron pirate party Sci-Hub Students for Free Culture People Alexandra Elbakian Rickard Falkvinge Lawrence Lessig Richard Stallman Peter Sunda Peter Suber Aaron Swartz Documentaries Steal This Film 2006, 2007 Good Copy Bad Copy 2007 Rip, A Remix Manifesto 2008 TPBAFK, The Pirate Bay Away From Keyboard 2013 The Internet's Own Boy 2014